Hello. So this video is actually very important, and it's a shortcut for an equation for black in the classical variation. So e4 c6 d4 d5 knight c3 d knight e4 bishop e5 knight g3 bishop g6 h4 h6 knight f3 e6 h5 bishop h7 bishop d3 bishop d3 queen d3 knight f6 bishop d2 c5 and knight e4. So we did set that after knight c6 white plays bishop c3 and he could not find an equality. Well, I don't think so. Now white should prepare something new in the classical Karakhan defense, because I saw no advantage for white at all. For example, knight f6 now, queen f6, d takes c5, queen b2, castles, and black should improve with the easy move bishop c5, rook b1, queen a3, queen a3, bishop a3, rook b7, and just castle. So the endgame, I think it's an equal position. If d takes c5, then queen d3, cd, knight e4, d, and bishop c5. So it's a very easy game for black. Rook c1, bishop b6, that was the game of 3f, this black is an equal position. And bishop c3, then just bishop b4, exchanging everything. Rook c1, bishop c3, rook c3, king e7, Bednikova, Antonov, with an equal position. Castles alone. Well, it's not a good idea, because after cd knight f6, black just plays queen f6, then castles long, winning the pawn, Andronov, Komarov. And now we come to two main white options. So the first option is interesting move knight c5. I don't know why this move is played rarely. Black plays bishop c5, d6, queen d3, cd, and makes castles. And now white should play king e2, because if b4, then rook d3, b5, knight d4, knight e5, and now the tactical madness starts. Knight c2, king e2, rook d5, knight f7, and very good move, knight e4. Knight takes h8, rook d2, king f3, knight g5, king g3, knight a1, rook a1, and knight e4, king f3, knight c5. Malisauskas Rostitso, and now black is slightly better. Just look at the h8 knight and b5 and h5 pawns. Another move in that critical position is d4, but it's a mistake. Knight d4, rook d4, bishop b3, because rook d5, and how to protect h5 pawn. Rook d1, rook h8, rook d5, rook d5, rook h4, rook h5. Peeling against Giria, and black was just pawn up. If rook h4, then rook d3, bishop c3. And here black should have played rook h8, rook c1, and very important move e5. So the point of that move, white cannot take the pawn, and white cannot protect the c5 pawn from d4 with the bishop. King d2, rook 3, d5, b4. And another point of pawn f5 was e4. Knight d2, knight d4, king d1, rook h5, rook h5, knight f5, rook, sorry, knight e4, rook e8, f3, knight f3, gf, and f5. And the position is equal. Bishop c3, or rook d3, bishop f6, gf, rook h4, rook g8, king f1. Padera Starostis. Here, black should have played f5. The idea of playing rook g4 before and rook g4, so that bishop takes f6 move was just a bad move, because white loses a pawn. So I think that the critical move is king e2. We should try rook d5, and I think that white should play b4, because if bishop b3, rook hd8, if our rook hd1, we just take on h5, f3, a5, protecting against b4, and black is better, or d4. Now it's a good moment to play e5 immediately, d, knight e5, knight e5, and rook e5. And I think that the position is equal. Block once play knight h5, rook h5, knight g4, knight takes e3, and rook c5. So the critical move is rook ad1. And now maybe it's the starting point of looking for something for white, because I don't like the move knight h5 or rook takes h5. White's play is easy, d4, a3, b4, and so on. I found that e5 move. So black plays for long time compensation for the pawn. a3, a5, rook d2, knight g4. Rook c1, f5, g3, knight f6. So the position is complex, but I think that it requires practical preparation. I think we could see some more games in that line, because really in the line we will see next, I don't think that white can find any ideas. Maybe the endgame is white's best. So b4 it's the most popular move, but after rook h8, b5, knight d4, knight d4, rook d4, and rook h3, protecting the pawn, because bishop b3, rook d3, c6. Another game of starosti with black. Here, black should have played rook h3, protecting the pawn. Black is better. So rook h3, Rožič against Zeljčič, and here black should have played rook a8 to d5, not rook 4 to d5, because that rook is useful to play rook a4 at some point. For example, rook f3, rook e5, bishop e3, rook b4, a4, rook takes h5, and I think that black has a good position. So that was a first critical move, knight takes e5, and I think we will see some endgame from that particular position. But the critical test was that move bishop c3, and Vidit says in his video that he could not find an equality for black, but c takes d4. If now knight f6, then queen f6, it's a novelty. Queen f6, knight d4, and the point of move queen f6 is that after bishop b4, black has an intermediate check, queen e5, king f1, and knight b4, and it's an equal position. So knight takes d4, and last year Van Gaal found a good move in that particular position. I think that it's a deep opening preparation, because if knight d4, that move looks like logical. Bishop d4, queen a5, c3, knight d4, queen a4, and if black plays queen d5, exchanges the queen, that it's just one-way ticket. Otherwise, black has problems with developing the bishop. But Van Gaal found the move knight b4. And if now queen b5, then queen d7, and in both cases, after knight f6, g takes f6, or queen d7, king d7, knight f6, g takes f6, it's a transposition to the main line. So knight takes f6, g takes f6, and we have second critical position. So Van Gaal's opponent VE tried bishop b4. Maybe queen b5 is more critical try. Queen d7. And last year another game was played, Nemtsov against Ley, bishop b4, but I think that move is not critical. Queen b5, knight b5, bishop b4, c3, bishop a5. So maybe a better move was now b4, bishop b6, c4, a6, knight d6, king d7, c5, but black has a good move in that particular position, a5. Attacking the b4 pawn, and after knight b7, rook hb8, c takes b6, rook b7, it's just a dead draw, I think. So knight d6, king d7, castles. So knight b7 now is a mistake, bishop b6 before, and rook ab8, and black is better. Rook ag8, attacking the pawn, g3, and here small improvement, rook ab8, and I think that the position is equal, but with some winning chances for black. The game white played badly and white lost the game. But the critical move, I think, is queen d7, king d7, rook d1, knight d5, and bishop d2, rook c8, c3. So I tried to analyze that position with the engine for several hours, that particular position. Found that the engine just gives rook g8 and says that it's just 0.0, but I wouldn't be surprised that we will see some more games in that from that position, because the position is far from balanced. Black has weak pawn structure, black has a weak h6 pawn. However, white has also weaknesses, h5, g2, for example, now is weak. So very unbalanced position, and I think that maybe we will see more theoretical games in that line. So bishop b4 was played, bishop b4, c3, bishop e7. If now queen f3, aimed against queen d5, then queen c7, castles, knight g4, rook h8, rook h1, and rook g5 is idea of playing rook g5, so black has no problems. Castles long was played, and in the game black played queen d7, but queen d5 is best solution. King b1, castles long, g4, rook d7 with idea of playing rook h8, queen e2, rook h8. And I think that black has really zero problems from that position. So let's make some conclusions. I think that that move c5 is playable due to the line knight d4, knight c6, and the critical move is bishop c3, and after cd, knight d4, Van Gaal found that solution knight b4. And we should study that stuff carefully, and maybe white can found some improvements in the line with knight takes c5, and in the line queen b5, queen d7, queen d7, queen d7, rook d1. So stay tuned and see modern games in that line. But I hope you now have a good opening repertoire against the classical variation of the Karakhan defense. So thanks for watching this video series, and see you again soon. Goodbye.